In this video, I'd like to show how to find t-critical values or t-scores for confidence intervals. You need a t-table. Also, you need to know what the confidence intervals and critical values are before starting. Here is a t-table we use. The first column shows the degrees of freedom, which we can find by subtracting one from the sample size. The top row shows the confidence level. The intersection of those gave t-scores. Comparing to the standard normal distribution, the shape of t-distributions depends on the sample size. The t-distribution is used if we don't know the standard deviation of the population sigma. There are two steps to find t-critical values for confidence intervals. However, before starting, check to see if the population standard deviation sigma is given or not. Check the second condition, either the sample size is more than or equal to 30, or the population is normally distributed. Step 1. Identify the given confidence level of a question. Step 2. Find the degrees of freedom by subtracting one from the sample size. Then look up the table. Please keep in mind that our table gives only positive t-scores. However, we should have both positive and negative t-critical values. Let's take a look at the first example. Finding t-critical values for 99% confidence level with a sample size of 12. Assume that the population standard deviation sigma is unknown, and the population is normally distributed. Step 1. Identify the given confidence level, 99% for this question. Step 2. Find the degrees of freedom by subtracting one from the sample size 12, which is 11. Then look up the table. First, locate 11 degrees of freedom. Then select 99% confidence level from the top row. Then read the intersection of those to get the t-score as 3.106. Now we found the positive critical value 3.106. We should have the negative critical value minus 3.106 as well. So the critical values are plus or minus 3.106 for the 99% confidence level with the sample size of 12. Let's take a look at the second example. Finding t-critical values for 95% confidence level with the sample size of 34. Assume that the population standard deviation sigma is unknown. Since the sample size is more than 30, the second condition is satisfied. Step 1. Identify the given confidence level, 95%, for this question. Step 2. Find the degrees of freedom by subtracting one from the sample size 34, which is 33. Then look up the table. First, locate 33 degrees of freedom. Then select 95% confidence level from the top row. Then read the intersection of those to get the t-score as 2.035. Now we found the positive critical value 2.035. We should have the negative critical value minus 2.035 as well. So the t-critical values are plus or minus 2.035 for the 95% confidence level with a sample size of 34. In summary, we need to identify the confidence level and the degrees of freedom to look up the tea table. Please make sure to state both positive and negative critical values, since our tea table only gives positivity scores. Thank you for watching and see you again.